I am very glad to see everybody here after 4 years of seeing nobody anywhere. It was quite a trip. Would you fix that, please? Or are my ears ringing?
That's, how old are you?
Two.
How are you so tall?
I grew a lot during COVID. Yeah. It has been a road getting here because of the supply chain issues and the employee issues and the trucking issues and everything else. So what I'm going to tell you is take everything here with a grain of salt and just maximize your presence. Be here and be in the moment, and you'll take away a lot from this meeting. I am just really happy and really surprised that this many people made it here because it's been a long trip. Tonight we have a very special performance. We have collected art from all of the KT members internationally, and we've had quite a number of submissions, and we were originally going to do some live performances, but we had so many entries that we decided to put everybody on a slide, and so I'm going to start them and tell you a little bit about each person. And if I can figure out how Stefan's clicker works, then we're good. Okay? First of all, you'll notice that the logo here is I'm Possible, because there is no such thing as impossible. This is the most I'm Possible group of people I've ever met, and I'm impressed. So I'm impressed that you're I'm Possible. Yes, mind meld. That's the word. Our first artist is Melissa. She was born and raised in Chicago, and she has a passion for the Cubs. She started painting about a year ago to help with her anxiety and found out that she loved it. Some of her paintings have great meaning. Others are simply free-flowing, but they all somehow reflect her. She has three submissions. Next, we have Michael. Michael is 31. He's from upstate New York. He is an artist and a designer. He loves 3D printing and making things from scratch with 3D modeling. He is a collector, and his collecting can be expensive, and it is very difficult with the rare items that he collects. He's also an author. So he makes replicas of what he cannot afford. The first piece is his most recent recreation, which is a copy of an original Coney Island steeplechase park decoration. This piece was digitally sculpted and 3D printed over 180 hours in 7 pieces. He then made a mold to make plaster copies. The second piece is a recreation of the 1904 Mills Roaring Lion Lung Tester arcade machine, built only from the picture on the right without ever having seen one in person. The third piece is a piece of digital art that he made, which is his favorite piece that he's done ever digitally. This is Annabelle's piece. She is 16. She lives with her parents and her cat Daisy and her bunny Fufu. She is homeschooled, and she's a member of Mensa. She loves coloring, creating cricket projects, gaming with her friends around the world, and following motorsports. She hopes to go into healthcare one day to help others with chronic illnesses. Adam Cole, for as long as he can remember, has spent his Saturday nights at a local asphalt racetrack near his home in Roxboro, North Carolina. from a fan in the stands as a child. He was able to become involved in the sport as crew chief for his brother at the Orange County Speedway and South Boston Speedway from 1997 to 2012. Over that course of time, he earned multiple wins, two track championships, and the Crew Chief of the Year Award in 2007. When he moved on from his race family team after 16 years, he still couldn't step away from the sport. But now at 41 years of age, he finds himself at the track most weekends. Beginning in 2013, he became a member of the radio broadcast team at South Boston Speedway. He broadcasts each race live on the radio. In 2022, we also became the voices of the online live stream for the Speedway. In addition to his family race team, he's proud to be a part of the family furniture and mattress business. Advertisement is extra. They've been blessed to be in business for 46 years and to have most of his immediate family still involved in the business. Inspired by one of his best friends, he participated in this photo shoot in 2021. He knocked down self-esteem barriers that he had struggled with in the past, and this was an opportunity to celebrate that accomplishment. In the past, he had hidden his KT-affected leg and essentially hid the disorder from all of those around him. With encouragement from his wife, he was able not only to become comfortable in his own skin, but now begin to embrace it and embrace being uniquely me. Him. As his friend noticed his change and learned of his past, she offered this photo opportunity as a birthday gift that he could fully embrace the journey that he had taken. He happily accepted, knowing that he could use these photos to inspire others to become comfortable in their skin as well. It was an unbelievable feeling, and he wanted others to feel the same. When challenged with choosing a location, Boston Speedway was an easy choice. Racing has been a background for all of his life, so it was fitting for that to be in the same photo shoot. I've seen the rest of this series, and they're awesome. That rocks. Multimedia's artist Kat is a Kansas-born Tennessean who expresses her creativity in multiple art forms. Dogs, friends, family, and advocacy are her primary daily motivators. Next, we have Diamond. Diamond is a girl of 10 years old, and she is in basic five. She lives in Africa. She is fair in complexion. She loves to sing and dance, draw and paint. She also likes to read and learn new things. She likes traveling, and she's humble and honest. She dislikes lies, and she dislikes cheating. She loves art, especially in singing and dancing, as well as painting. Her mother can attest to it. She always decorates her room with some of her artworks. Even in school, she participates actively when it comes to art. Art makes her optimistic about the future. It is the way that she can confidently express herself and possibly relay her message to people around the world in a message of hope, peace, and love, which goes a way to uplift spirits. She loves art, and she finds it fascinating because it makes everyone feel alive and active. You'll see more from Diamond later. Hi, everybody. This is Christian's work. Christian is 32 years old and lives in Milwaukee with his wife, Lene, and his two-year-old daughter, Cece. He has been coming to these conferences since he was a kid, and he works as a full-time fine artist, and that is exciting because it has been a long-time dream of his that he realized last year. He sells his personal work to collectors. He creates custom commissions and murals, and occasionally dabbles in graphic design. The last time he saw us, he was working in an urban education as a high school art teacher. His passions are pretty much all things art related. In addition to painting, he has a special fondness for film, and weightlifting. As a family, he likes swimming, going to beer gardens, and volunteering with his church. His artist statement is hope, gratitude, and perseverance are the most consistent themes in his artwork. He has worked in different styles over the years, but his work comes from a very different personal place and has been greatly influenced by his experiences as a disabled person. Born Different from 2010. This is a very overtly influenced by his experiences with KT. This piece blends three body parts with KT or similar vascular disease into a unified abstract form. It celebrates the unique physical differences and genetic connectedness. The second picture is a box of optimism from 2019. This is a whimsical piece. There are many ways to interpret this painting, but he likes to think of this as a celebration of the pervading power of ways to interpret this painting. The pervading power of optimism and hope. This is more representative of his current style, figurative mixed media with vivid colors and unique patterns. The one with the basilisk from 2020. In simple terms, this is a piece about facing challenges, internal or external. If you find the KT-related work particularly fascinating, check out his website at christiansis.com and click the undergrad section. If you want to stay informed about his newer work, feel free to follow him on Instagram as @christiansis. Katie is a family girl, Midwest family girl, and a licensed mental health therapist and registered play therapist. She's mom to three darling little people, and she is a KT warrior. She's sharing this photo collage artwork of her and her daughter, Rianne. Her daughter's completely darling, wild at heart, lover of all animals and nature. When KT moments are difficult, her daughter motivates her to keep going. She has known and will continue to know that beauty comes in all shapes and sizes. KT does not stop her, does not stop Katie from being the best mom that she can be. They love picking mulberries at their acreage in South Dakota. The berries are a beautiful deep color and impossible to eat without dyeing your hands and face. So they took photos of their faces snacking on them. One day she said, "Oh, I match mommy." She also did a poem, and if I can see it from here, "The road I didn't choose, I wouldn't have taken it had I been given a choice at all. Often lonely, rarely easy, complicated to say the least. Given a choice, I'd take a different road. The pain holds steady as ever-present reminder of my weakness, clouding my mind, wounding conversations, siphoning joy from days long spent, dreamt about. And in its wake, I'm left to ask, how different would I be if it were gone? Then there are the times I'm empowered to be battling something so unknown, like I'm blazing a trail, leaving my tracks, a Lovenox packed, footprints noticeably mismatched. So that is where you'll find me, a split household of motivation and defeat, on the road I didn't choose, moving forward, limping leaps. I didn't choose this road, but I'll travel it the best I can." She thinks of that as a my experience poem and works with people on their mental health and struggles and uses that poem. She used the intervention on herself as well regarding her experience with KT, and the artwork was the result. Whoops, sorry. Joellen Preston, first of all, I have to give a little bit of an acknowledgement. When when we conceived to do this piece, Joellen is an artist, and she stepped forward and said, "I can't come to the conference, but I'd like to put this together for you." So all of this was done by Joellen, and she did the collecting, she did the assembling, she did the PowerPoint, so I am really just mouthing Joellen's work, and she is with her parents on their 50th wedding anniversary. So, thanks, Joellen. She is an artist and an educator, an arts educator, as well as a musician, poet, and gardener. She does all forms of art, though most of them have some sort of drawing or illustrative style to them. Everything she makes tells a story. When she's working with students, either young or adults, she tries to get them to understand there is no one way to make art and no specific material that needs to be used. Art is creative expression, whatever that ends up being for you. We'll hear more about this, and she actually reads these pieces for us later. But I thought we would include them here because they're kind of interesting just from an art standpoint. Anybody identify with that? This is David. David is 7 years old, and he's from Tampa, Florida. He loves to draw, and he wanted to share some of his creative works. I don't know if you can see the intricacy there, but it's really detailed. That one I think is my favorite, and I like the little puppy dog cloud in the sky. I don't know. Amanda is 45 years old, and since the age of 12, she decided to turn her pain into passion. Basically, she made the decision to beat KT and live an active and normal life. She got a degree in corporate fitness and wellness and has obtained many nationally accredited certifications and help others on a daily basis with their health and their wellness. Stay positive and never give up. That's her message to you. So she sent us several pictures of herself doing her art. My husband liked that one. This is Kai. Kai is 10 years old and she is from Arizona. Her family and her sister are traveling around the country, and she loves to draw places that she's seen. She loves to ride horses. She dreams to travel to Hawaii and other islands. Her art is about nature. She likes to draw nature. I believe that one's a collaboration with her sister. This is Ronald. Ronald is 57 years old, and he plans to retire at 60, which is doing better than I did. He works for the state of Wisconsin as a legal secretary. He is looking forward to traveling after he retires. He enjoys arts, crafts, sewing, quilting, and baking of all kinds. Being creative is what he lives for. He plans to make many more creations after he retires. Ronald, can I ask you a question? Are you a native of Oklahoma? He laughed? Wow, okay. I think his biography got scattered here. I think this is also him. I'm a native of Oklahoma, and I've lived here most of his life. Headed to 66. No, it's not. That's him? Okay, headed to 66 in retirement soon after a long career as a geologist. He enjoys almost any outdoor activity that gets him away from the city and onto a river, creek, pond, lake, woods, open plains, or just about any country setting. His art started as a fourth grader, bored with class, but fascinated with pictures in the history book, which he rendered with pencil on ruled paper. He thinks this one was done in the sixth grade, possibly fifth, painted from a picture in the National Geographic magazine. He was taught oil painting by a professional artist. Okay, I'm missing one somewhere. This is Carly. Carly is 57 years old and plans to retire at 60. There's all these retirement plans in here. She works for the state of Wisconsin. Oh God, now I got it. Okay. As a legal secretary, she is looking forward to traveling after she retires, and she does a lot of crafting and artwork. She told me that these pieces were jewelry that belonged to her mother-in-law after she passed. Carly made these pieces for members of the family. Whoops, now we are on to guess who did that. This is Sinead and Foreman. Sinead and her constant best friend companion, four-year-old Labrador Golden Retriever Cross Foreman, loved to paint together. Foreman was born in Israel and trained there for almost 2 years to be a life-saving service dog. He traveled across the world to Canada to finish training and to meet his person, Sinead. In their downtime, Foreman enjoys snoozing, painting. His art has actually been sold on Etsy. He's a professional artist, making TikTok videos, playing fetch, and swimming. Sinead enjoys advocacy and reaching out to help others. Their other best friend is little Charlie, who is a gorilla at the zoo, and they are dedicated to advocating for gorilla conservation. Foreman's favorite thing about traveling is that he always gets the window seat. This painting is called Endless Possibilities because that's what they hope for all people. This is Tatum. Tatum is 14 years old and she lives in South Africa. Her mom and dad and brother are all into sports, but living with her condition has made it impossible for her to do sports. She found love and passion for art. Her mom sent her to art class and she loves every minute of it. She wants to be an artist or a chef when she grows up. Art is her passion and her escape. I think her use of color is exciting. I haven't figured out if that's leaves or if it's something under a microscope. You see it? Okay, this is Evelyn. Evelyn is 10 years old and she lives with three little brothers and a great mom and dad in southeastern Pennsylvania. I put that in there for you because you know your mom's great. She loves reading, Legos, Pokemon, camping, and learning. And I love the ice cream. This is Lily. Lily is from Nebraska, from Lincoln, Nebraska. She's passionate about wheelchair basketball and tennis. She wants to make sure all people have the opportunity to play, no matter where they live. She dreams to be a Paralympian someday. This is her senior solo dance. And we're actually going to see in a minute the dance. Now I have to tell you before I start this is her parents filming this at a high school performance. So it's a little rough in the beginning, and I'm not sure how the music is going to play here, but I think that watching her, you'll understand that it was important for you to see this.
I wasn't born a renegade. I felt alone, still feel afraid. I still feel it anyway. Are there someone who would tell me that this life is ours to choose? No one's handing you the keys or a book with all the rules. Little do I know, I'll tell you. When they dress you up in lies and you let me
me to tell you guys that she is really missing being here, but she does have a conflicting event, and it has to do with the Paralympics. So she's trying out for Paralympics now. So she was here last time, though. This is Kat's poetry. I'm just going to introduce it like that.
This is my response when somebody asks me what my pain is from 1 to 10. How do I explain to somebody what my pain is like when they have no idea what it's like to sit in the still, in the haunting darkness, in the deafening silence? Silence is so loud. I look in the mirror, but all I can see is shattered glass. I know it's me, but that image is unrecognizable. In one hand, I'm holding serenity, but in the opposite, malice. I was born with this malice. For a long time, my pain swallowed me whole. It suffocated my scars, and it fed on my very will to survive. I reached for someone. No one was there. The tricks were in my head said I'd be better off dead, and you want to know what my pain is between 1 and 10. What is my pain between 1 and 10? It's the dehydration of my soul. It's the sound of my heart and my scream becoming one. It is the flame that ignites the fire. It is surrendering to something that is so unholy, it is a lost hope. Ask me again what my pain is from 1 to 10. It's not even on the page.
This is Molly. This is Molly. Molly is a child of James and Marcella Casey, who enjoys walking, swimming, gardening, who loves to eat potatoes, soup, and peanut butter, and jelly. Who hates negative attitudes, going to confession, and fish. Who wants to go back to Fort Walton Beach, who wishes she could have met her grandparents, who is scared of rats and mice, who belongs to St. Bernard's Parish, who dreams of winning the lottery and sharing it with others, who is determined to make a difference in the lives of as many children as possible, who values close relationships with God, husband, family, and friends, who is proud of her heritage, family, and former students who graduated from St. Xavier University, who lives in Homer Glen but often hangs out in LaGrange Park in Chicago.
Hello, KT family, it's Molly, and I'm here to share two poems with you today. I hope everybody's feeling good, I'm feeling great, and I hope you enjoy my poems today. My first poem is called Me. Irish, Catholic, Democrat, teacher, walker, wears storyteller hat. Happy, funny, nose always runny. Glass half full, positive, nice, at times, willing to pay full price. Family, friends, socializing. Scary movies I find horrifying. Nice house, no animals, just cotton smelling candles. Loving husband, inspirational, caring, irreplaceable. Not a shopper, beach hopper, church goer, Eucharistic minister, tries to be a really good listener. KT, it's just a part of me. South Sider, White Sox, Blackhawks, Chicago Bears. As for the rest, I don't care. I hope you enjoyed it.
We liked it so well that Molly's going to do a second piece for us.
I'm back. For my second poem, it's called Lessons Learned. As I sit here looking at my first grade report card, I don't see any pluses, and I definitely needed to work on a few subjects. But I quickly learned it was never about my grades back then. It was what my first grade teacher, Angela, said to me. Every now and then, my teacher would bend down and say, Molly, you can do it. I wasn't so sure. My family agreed with my teacher. And if I was unsure, they would say, what would Angela say? It was those five words, Molly, you can do it, that my teacher said to me in the first grade that have followed me all these years. Like when I was learning to drive and I wasn't so sure, I heard, what would Angela say? Molly, you can do it. And I did it. Like when I was thinking of going to SXU and I wasn't sure I could get in, I heard, what would Angela say? Molly, you can do it. And I did it. Like when I was thinking of becoming a first grade teacher, and I wasn't so sure I could do it like my favorite first grade teacher, I heard, what would Angela say? Molly, you can do it. And I did it. Like when I was thinking of buying my first house, and I wasn't so sure, I heard, what would Angela say? Molly, you can do it. And I did it. Since I left the first grade, no one has asked me about that report card. But I sure am glad my teacher said to me, Molly, you can do it. If only every teacher believed in their students like my favorite first grade teacher, Angela. I hope you like my poems, and I'm looking forward to seeing and catching up with everybody. Bye now.
Okay, we had told you we'd see Diamond again. I saved part of her information for this. This is she was able to compose a song when she was as little as 3 years old. Since then, she has been able to compose about 14 songs, of which her mother was able to assist in recording into an album. In the album, she has about 10 tracks. She is known as Dazzling Diamond in her music career. Though the album Untouchable is yet to be launched and released because of challenge of funds, she chose to share it with us tonight. impressive. Huh? Diamond and her mother tried to come, and we wrote probably 12 letters to the embassy. And unfortunately, travel from Africa to the United States right now is just not a real possibility. So, you know, but she says to send everyone a hello. I talk to her routinely, and she will be thrilled to know that you liked her music. I will ask her. Honey, she wrote the song, I'm Possible. Yes.
Okay, because I was like,
yes.
That just okay, that's
she wrote your theme. Did it take you a lot long to pick that up?
I gotta pick that up.
Yeah. But, you know, they just keep getting better. And I think last we have Erinny, who is a senior studying music technology at the University of Alabama at Birmingham. I already raised your expectations, didn't I? That's UAB. And she has been singing, playing guitar, and songwriting for about 10 years, which is how long Diamond's been alive. Currently, she is the lead singer and lyricist for indie folk duo Heather and Hay, along with guitarist Garrett Reeves. All My Love was the band's debut single, and received praise from Grammy Award-winning pop producer Jack Antonoff. Heather and Hay continues to release music and has a new single coming out soon, and Erinny plans to release some of her solo work in the near future as well.
Like the ocean, and all that's between us is concrete and cars. There's a bittersweet taste in my mouth since your birthday, when we were just two bloody hearts. And my passenger seat feels a little more empty without a warm body and fists full of song. It's a quiet kind of heartbreak when you don't write me. Did all of our years used to last this long? And all my love, wherever you lie, peace will come if we only survive. That you left me and told me to carefully keep in my chest. The birds out to get me and perish the memory. Shiny love seems to be all I've got left. There's a hole in the place where I hide you and I, and the slow buoy leak down the hallway. And it seems to me faster your glittery humor fades. And all my love, wherever you lie, peace will come if we only survive.
Ernie, that's beautiful. Would you stand up, please, and stand up and take a bow, please? We all know it's you, okay? Thank you. We'll hire you for the next meeting. I told you that we would visit Joellen's poetry again. And this is kind of a combined method of art that she does, and I'm going to let her tell you about it.
My name is Joellen Preston, and I'm a visual artist and poet. It can be hard to create art from nothing. That's why we look for inspiration in nature, in people, in the world around us. This is true for visual art like paintings and drawings, as well as literary arts like stories and poetry. I use a technique called found poetry that uses pages from books to give me inspiration. I look at the words individually, and I circle the ones that jump out at me. I connect each word together, creating a poem that is completely new and separate from the original book page. As I'm writing the poem, I illustrate it with images and colors to make it come alive. I'm going to read a couple for you now. Look at my hair. It's green. An earthly color, if thought so grotesque, how little you know me. I was meant to be a beautiful that feels like the truth. If you just loved cheerful things even in wintertime, perhaps I'd never see it again, that feeling of despair. You wanted the worst, but a better time could come and turn your consciousness back to the wild sun and morning. She glimpses the prettiest things year after year, sown only here. Mother lives with a fancy heart. Mother was the secret. She was the whole, beautiful, thrilling secret. Do not count the silence. You can only feel until you laugh. Hooray!
I hope that you enjoyed this. I do have one other thing that I'd like to point out. I would like for three young ladies to come forward and stand up and take a bow, please. These ladies made bracelets, and on their own, weren't asked, they brought them and shared them with you for a small donation or a large donation, if you prefer. And they turned over about $250 to us this afternoon. Primo, I hope you enjoyed this. I certainly enjoyed post-assembling it after Joellen had done such a beautiful job, but I'm glad to share it with you tonight. And I think that's all. It's a little warm in here to me, but let's go and have a nice, pleasant evening or rest. Okay. Thank you.